Today we will do ships trading certificates. Now, these are the certificates without which ship cannot trade. That means she cannot sail to open sea. It is illegal to sail without having trading certificates, and it's against the law. Now, which are these trading certificates? There's international safe manning certificate, also known as minimum manning. This tells you how much minimum crew is required to be on board, like 3 engineers, 3 AVs, like that. Now, who decides this? How much minimum crew is required? It is decided by your ship owner along with the flag state. Basically, flag state decides it. And how do they decide? It is based on the degree of automation. For example, if engine room is unmanned, then less engineers are required. Then ship's cranes are there or not. If ship's cranes are there, you need more people on deck. So deck crew is increased. Then trading pattern. If ship goes to ice area, cold areas, you need more crew. If ships is normally trading in very short voyages, 2 days voyages, 3 days, you need more crew, like that. Now this expiry is lifelong, unless the ship changes the trading pattern or something. Second one is anti-fouling. This is about the anti-fouling pane. This is also lifelong. Safe manning, anti-fouling. Then international tonnage is also lifelong. This gives the gross tonnage, net tonnage of the ship, which is also lifelong. And unless the ship is modified, the construction is modified and the tonnage change, then a new certificate is issued. Then we have some certificates which are 5 yearly. Their 5 yearly renewal is there, and every 1 year you have to do the annual survey. For example, safety equipment, international road line, IOPP, International Oil Pollution Prevention Certificate. Then safety radio certificate. So these are 5 yearly, and how to calculate when will be the next annual survey due? So we have to see the expiry dates of these certificates. One is safety construction also. So if the expiry date, like now is a year 20, so if the expiry date is 14 July 25, this is the expiry of all these certificates or any one certificate. So how to calculate when will be the next annual due? So you have to work backwards. For example, if this is the expiry date of the certificate, then the annual before this date will be on the day, and the month will be the same. So it will be annual will be on 14 July 24. This is the fourth annual, and before that you'll have another annual on 14 July 23 and another one on 14 July 22, and the first annual will be on 14 July 21. First annual, second annual, third annual, fourth annual, and then renewal. So you will get a new certificate around this date. Now all these dates are having plus minus 3 months. So you can do the first annual on this date or plus minus 3 months. For example, you did this first annual on, let's say, 14th of June. So next annual after this will be due on this date. It has nothing to do with the date of the first annual. the day and month will remain the same. And again, there is plus minus 3 months. The expiry one does not have plus, but you can do it 3 months before. It has only minus 3 months. Then there are another two certificates which are to be renewed 5 years. They don't have annuals, but they have intermediate service. So one of them is safety management certificate. And another one is international ISPS certificate, international SIP security certificate. So if these are getting expired on this date, so how to calculate the date of their intermediate survey? From this date, 14 July 25, you have to minus 2.5 years and you get a date. Let's say whatever you got, 14th March 22 or 23, whatever you got, minus 2.5 years. So this will be the date of the intermediate survey. And after that, there will be a renewal survey on this date. Now this intermediate survey has also got plus minus, not 3 months, but 6 months. And the renewal does not have any plus, but it has got minus 6 months. So these are the two additional certificates. So this is about the ship's trading certificates.